morning, students. Let's start question number 1. In a figure P parallel Q. P and Q, these are parallel lines, okay? And T is a transversal. See, this is T. T is a transversal. Find the value of A, B and C. Find the value of A, B and C. Give the reason to it. Means whatever we will get the value for A, B and C, that reason we have to write why we have got this value. Okay. So, now observe this figure. These two lines are parallelized. P and Q parallel lines and T is the transversal. Okay. So, now if you will see in this figure, this angle we know it is 70 degree. See, this angle is 70 degree. Okay. So, angle B is vertically opposite angle to 70 degree. Angle B is vertically opposite angle to 70 degree. So, angle B how much we will get? 70 degree. Why? Because vertically opposite angles are equal. Okay. So, angle B is equal to 70 degree. Why angle B is 70 degree? Because it is vertically opposite angle to 70 degree. Why? Angle B is 70 degree, that we have to write here reason. It is asked in the question, give the reason to it. Okay, so why angle B is 70 degree vertically opposite angle? Vertically opposite angle to 70 degree. Why angle B is 70 degree? Because B is vertically opposite angle to the 70 degree angle. To angle 70 degree. Okay. For 70 degree angle, it is vertically opposite angle. Okay. Then next. Now we got angle B 70 degree. Okay. Angle B we got 70 degree. So now if you will see angle B and angle A, these are alternate interior angles. See, which are the alternate interior angles? I show you. This way if it will come like S shape. See. Yes. So, these are the alternate interior angles. See. These are the inside of this both the lines and alternate interior angles. What to say for this angle? Alternate interior angles. So, alternate interior angles are equal. So now what we got? Angle B we got 70 degree. Okay. Now angle B and angle A. Angle B and angle A. These are alternate interior angles. Angle B is equal to angle A will come. Angle B is equal to angle A. Why angle B is equal to angle A? Because these are the alternate interior angles. Why angle B is equal to angle A? Alternate interior angles. So what will get the measurement of angle A? Measurement of angle A is equal to 70 degree. Measurement of angle A is equal to 70 degree. Why? Because B is equal to A. And why B is equal to A? Because these are the alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Okay. These both the angles are alternate interior angles. So, angle B how much we have? 70 degree. So, angle A is equal to 70 degree. Angle B is equal to 70 degree we got. So, angle A is equal to 70 degree. So, angle A is equal to 70 degree. Why angle A is equal to 70 degree we got? Because angle B and angle A both are alternate interior angles and alternate interior angles are equal. Okay. Now, next. Now, which angle it is remains? See, angle B we got 70 degree, angle A we got 70 degree. Okay. Now, which is next angle we have to find? Angle C. These angle we have to find. Angle C. Okay. Now, see. It has formed a linear pair. It has formed a linear pair. Angle C plus 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. Why? Angle C plus 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. It has congolinear pair. Okay. So angle C plus 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. Angle C plus 70 degree. It has formed the linear pair. Okay. It has formed the linear pair. Its measurement is supplementary. Okay. So here you will write the result linear pair. Okay. So angle C how much? Angle C is equal to, now we have 70 degrees here plus, if we will transfer to right hand side then it will become minus. So 180 degree minus 70 degree. So angle C is equal to 0 minus 0, 0, 8 minus 7, 1. So 110 degree. Why? See, angle C plus 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because it has formed the linear pair. So here write the reason. Linear pair. And linear pair measurement is supplementary. Or we can say these are the supplementary angles also. Here you can write the reason supplementary angles also. Okay. Let's solve question number 2. If DE parallel BC. DE parallel BC means these two lines are parallel lines. Find the values of x and y. Then we have to find the value of x and y in the given figure. What is given? DE and BC, these two parallel lines are there. See, these are the two parallel lines. So this is the transversal. These two lines, suppose these two lines are given parallel. It is given in the question DE parallel BC. So this is the transversal. This AB is the transversal. And AC is also transversal. Okay. These two lines are parallel line. DE and BC parallel lines. So AB and AC, these are the transversal. Okay. So see, this is the transversal. AB is the transversal. Means X and B. X and B are alternate interior angles. Yes or no? See, DE and BC are parallel lines. These two lines are parallel lines. So this is the transversal. AB is the transversal. First we think for this, then we will see for this. Okay. So AB is the transversal. This is transversal. This is transversal. Means this angle and this angle. Alternate interior angles. Okay. So angle X and this angle, B angle, these are the alternate interior angles. So angle X, see this angle. Angle X is equal to angle B. This angle. Angle X is equal to angle B. This angle. Okay. Angle X is equal to angle B. Or we can write angle A, B, C also. These are the equal. Why angle X and angle B are equal? Because these both the angles are alternate interior angles. Why these are equal? Alternate interior angles. Okay. Alternate interior angles. So angle X, how much we will get? 55 degree. Angle X is equal to angle B. Angle B is 55 degree. Then angle X is equal to 55 degree. Therefore, angle X is equal to 55 degree. Why angle X we got 55 degree understood? Because angle X and angle B both are equal. Equal by which? Alternate interior angles. Why these both the angles are equal? It is shown because angle X and angle B, these are alternate interior angles. See, these are alternate interior angles. Okay. So these both the angles are equal. So angle B we have 55 degree. So angle X also 55 degree. Okay. Now what it is asked, we have to find the value of Y also. Now this angle we have angles. So angle Y is equal to angle C. Is equal to angle C. Which angle? Angle Y is equal to angle C, or we can write angle A, C, B also. Okay, angle Y is equal to angle A, C, B. Why these both the angles are equal? These are also alternate interior angles. See, these are the parallel lines and this is the transversal. So angle Y and angle C, alternate interior angles. So write reason. Alternate interior angles. Okay, so these are the alternate interior angles. Now angles Y is equal to angle C. So angle Y, how much will get? Angle Y is equal to 80 degree. Why angle Y is equal to 80 degree? Because angle C is equal to 80 degree. We have, see, it is given. Angle C, angle A, C, B. This angle, it is 80 degree. So Y angle also 80 degree. Why Y angle is equal to 80 degree? Because angle C and angle Y are alternate interior angles. And alternate interior angles are equal. So angle Y is equal to 80 degree. What we got? Angle X is equal to 55 degree and angle Y is equal to 80 degree. Let's solve question number 3. Find the value of X if L parallel M. Find the value of X if L parallel M. This is what it is given in the question. L and M parallel lines. L and M parallel lines, and this is the transversal. L and M parallel, it is given. These two lines are parallel lines, means this is the transversal. Okay, this is the transversal. So these angle and these angles are equal. Now you will say, why equal, madam? These and these angles, why equal? Because these are the alternate interior angles. See, these are the parallel lines. See, this is inside of this, and this is also inside of this line. Okay, so, and see, alternate, it is alternate. It is this side of transversal and it is this side of transversal. So these are the alternate interior angles, and alternate interior angles are equal. So these angle and this angle, it is equal. Okay, so what is the measurement of given of for these angles? 7x plus 30 degree. So here I will write 7x plus 30 degree. Okay, is equal to 3x plus 50 degree. 3x plus 50 degree. This I'm not teaching, this is new. This all the concepts you have learned. Alternate interior angles, corresponding angles, vertically opposite angles, all the concepts you have learned. Linear pairs, supplementary angles, everything you have learned. Only these questions are depend on that concepts. Okay. Now 7x plus 30 degree is equal to 3x plus 50 degree. Why I have shown you equal? Because these angles measurement, it is given 7x plus 30 degree, and these angles measurement, it is given 3x plus 50 degree, and these both the angles are alternate interior angles. So these both the angles are equal. So here you can write reason. Alternate interior angles. Okay, these are the alternate interior angles. So these are the equal. So these angle and these angle I have shown here equal. And now solve this. Okay, now what we'll do here? Variables will keep together and numbers will take together. Okay, so now I'm writing here 7x. Okay, as it is. Now 30 is here plus. If we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become minus. Okay, so is equal to 3x plus 50 degree minus 30 degree. Okay, so what we will get? 7x is equal to 3x as it is. Okay, we should not add 3x in these. It is number with variable and this is only number. So don't add these. Okay. So now 50 degree minus 30 degree. What will get? 20 degree. Okay. So 20 degree plus 20 degree. Why plus 20 degree? See here, plus minus minus. And for answer greater number. So which is greater number in this book? 50 is the greater. So for answer for 20 is plus sign. Okay. Then now after that what we'll do? 3x will transfer to the left hand side. Okay. 7x as it is. 3x is here plus. If we will transfer to this side, then it will become minus. See, for 3 there is no sign, means it is plus sign. Okay. If we will transfer to left hand side, then it will become minus. So minus 3x is equal to. Now what will remain here? Here will remain only 20 degree. Why? See, 3x we have transferred to this side. So again don't write here. Okay. So now 7x minus 3x, 4x. 7x minus 3x, 4x. See, we can do the operation only. See, these both the numbers are with variables. So we can do this subtraction. Okay. So 7 minus 3, 4x. Okay. 7x minus 3x, 4x is equal to 20 degree. Okay. Now 4 is here multiplied. If we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become divide. So x is equal to 20 degree upon 4. Okay. So x is equal to 4 5s are 20. So x is equal to 5 degree. So what it is asked? Find the value of x. So x, how much we got? 5 degree. 4 1s are 4, 4 5s are 20. So x is equal to 5 degree. Let's solve question number 4. In the given figure, OA, OA and OB are opposite rays. These are the opposite rays. Okay. If x is equal to 35 degree, if x is equal to 35 degree, means x value it is given 35 degree, then find the value of y. Now what is given? In the given figure, OA and OB are opposite ray, means this is line, straight line. Okay, means this is line. So these angles are supplementary, it has formed the linear pair. So these angles are supplementary angles. So what we'll do? These angle plus these angle is equal to 180 degrees. See here, it is given OA and OB are opposite rays. These are the opposite rays. Okay, means these angles are supplementary angles. Which angle? These angle and these angle, it is supplementary angle. Okay, so 3x, or we can say it has formed the linear pair also, and linear pair measurement is supplementary. So 3x plus 2y minus 15 degree, 2y minus 15 degree is equal to, what will come? 180 degree. What we have to do? These angle plus these angle. These angle plus these angles. See, if you will see, these angles are supplementary angles. Okay, means with sum of these both the angles is 180 degree. Okay, it is not given anywhere. Means measurement of sum of these both the angles is 180 degree. It is not given in the question. This we have to observe in this figure. How we observe in the given figure? OA and OB are opposite rays. These are opposite rays. Okay. These are the opposite rays. It is given, means this is straight line. Okay. Means these angles are supplementary angles. These angles are supplementary angle, and supplementary angles measurement is 180 degree. So these angle plus these angle means 3x plus 2y minus 15 degree is equal to 180 degree. Now what it is given? If x is equal to, x value is given 35 degree. So let's put the value of x. Okay. So 3 into 35 degree. See, 3 into x. X value is given 35 degree. So 3 into 35 degree. Okay. Plus 2y 10, so 105 degree we got here. Okay, plus, now open this bracket, 2y minus 15 degree is equal to 180 degree. Okay, now see, we can do one thing. 105 minus 15 degree, we can do this operation. See, 105 degree, here I am writing these numbers together. 105 degree minus 15 degree plus 2y. See, just I have arranged here only these numbers together. Okay, is equal to 180 degree. Remaining things I have kept as it is. Okay, now 105 minus 15 degree, how much we will get? See, 5 minus 5, 0. 5 minus 5, 0. 10 minus 1, 9. Okay, so what we got answer? 90 degree here we got for this. Okay, plus 2y is equal to 180 degree. Okay, now 90 degree is here plus. If we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become minus. So 2y as it is equal to 180 degree. Now this 90 degrees here plus, if we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become minus. So 180 degree minus 90 degree. So 2y is equal to 180 minus 90, 90 degree we will get. Okay, so 2y is equal to 90 degree we got here. Okay, so y is equal to, see, 2y means 2 multiplied by y. If we will transfer 2 to the right hand side, then it will become divide. See, 2y means 2 multiplied by y. So if we will transfer 2 to the right hand side, then it will become divide. So 90 divided by 2. Okay, so y is equal to 90 divided by 2, 45. See, here you can do the lowest term, 2 ones are 2. 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10. So 45 degree. So what we got? Y is equal to 45 degree. What it is asked? Find the value of y. So y is equal to 45 degree.